Dear viewers, we have been discussing the provisions of VAT deduction at source. We have discussed the provisions of VAT deduction at source on services. We have seen on 37 services, VDS deduction is compulsory under all circumstances. We have seen the provisions of VDS provisions on advertising agency. Now we shall discuss VDS provision on goods. Hopefully in the next two tutorials we shall conclude this. These are the basic provisions regarding VDS. On goods, when VDS has to be deducted and when VDS has not to be deducted, this is a major concern at the field level. When goods has been procured by withholding entity, we have already discussed that there are 10 withholding entities. When goods have been purchased by them, concerned official, when making payment of the goods, has to understand that who the vendor who has supplied goods to the procuring entity, what is the status of the supplier vendor. There can be three status: one, manufacturer supplier; two, trader supplier; and three, procurement provider supplier. Now we shall discuss the provisions on each of these suppliers. On manufacturer supplier, the VDS provision is very easy. When a manufacturer supplier has supplied goods to any withholding entity directly with VAT 11, then VDS deduction is not needed. When a manufacturer supplier has supplied goods to any procuring entity without issuing VAT 11, then VDS has to be deducted at the rate of 15%. Let me put an example. Suppose a cement manufacturing factory has supplied cement to a developer company. The developer company is withholding entity. So when the developer company is making payment, then VDS regulations has to be followed. So what is the VDS regulation? The VDS regulation is, here the supply of cement is goods. Goods has been supplied by a manufacturer directly to the withholding entity. So our rule is, when manufacturer directly sells goods to the procuring to the withholding entity with VAT 11, i.e. VAT invoice, then VDS deduction is not needed. So here VDS deduction is not needed. When any manufacturer sells goods directly to any withholding entity without VAT 11, then 15% VDS has to be deducted. In this case of the supply of cement by a manufacturer to a developer company, had there not been VAT 11, then 15% VDS was required to be deducted, not 5%. At the field level, sometimes there is misunderstanding that 5% VDS has to be deducted here. This is a wrong concept. 15% VDS has to be deducted here. VDS has to be deducted there at the rate what was originally applicable. So we have been discussing VDS deduction procedure on goods. So on goods, there are three components: supply by manufacturer, supply by trader, supply by procurement provider. We have covered supply by manufacturer. Now let us come to the point of supply by trader. Supply by trader is almost similar to supply by manufacturer. When a trader supplies goods to the withholding entity with VAT 11, then VDS deduction is not needed. When a trader supplies goods to withholding entity without VAT 11, then VDS has to be deducted at the rate of 5%. Let us put an example. Who are trader? Distributor, dealer, commission agent, retailer, wholesaler, super shop, departmental store, general store, these are trader. In VAT parlance, he is trader who purchases the goods and sells the goods without doing any work on it. If any work is done on the goods, like packing or any other work, this is called manufacturing. So, trader, when a trader sells goods directly to any procuring entity, any withholding entity, with VAT 11, the provision is there shall require no VDS deduction. When a trader supplies goods to a withholding entity, VAT withholding entity, without VAT 11, then 5% VDS has to be deducted. Let us put an example. Suppose a super shop has supplied some boxes of tissue to a hotel. The hotel is a withholding entity, and super shop is a trader. The super shop issues ECR receipt that is considered as VAT 11. So here, super shop has supplied a tissue to hotel. Hotel is at withholding entity, super shop is trader, and the ECR receipt is considered as VAT 11. So trader has supplied goods with VAT 11 to a VAT withholding entity, here no VDS is to be deducted. Had there not been ECR receipt or any other VAT 11, 5% VAT would have been required to be deducted. Now the third type of supplier is procurement provider. Procurement provider is a very tricky concept. We shall discuss in next tips. Procurement provider generally provides goods. It procures goods from one place and it provides goods to another place. There is difference between procurement provider and trader. It shall be discussed. Procurement provider is considered a service in VAT parlance of Bangladesh. Procurement provider service is included in the list of compulsory VDS deduction, which has been discussed before some time. The rule is, when goods has been taken from procurement provider, then VDS has to be deducted at the rate of 5%. It is compulsory. So now we have covered all the services and all the goods, but in the next tips we shall discuss procurement provider in details, because at the field level this is very much needed. Dear viewers, please stay with us.